Residents in Queensland have embraced solar power, installing rooftop panels in unprecedented numbers. It's helped the state government to meet its solar energy target more than 3 years ahead of schedule. But solar still only accounts for 3.5% of Queensland's total energy generation. The industry says more incentives are needed to help businesses make the change. Emma Pollard reports.
Queenslanders have long been sun worshippers. Its abundant rays help shape our way of life and act as a potent calling card. Walk into the sunshine, bring it on. This love affair now extends to solar power. Across the southeast, glimmering rooftop panels dot the suburbs. About 1 in 20 homes have taken advantage of government subsidies and are harnessing the sun's rays.
People want to do the right thing.
But beyond the home, the question remains. Is solar power a viable energy source on a commercial and industrial scale? At the state's oldest university, the sandstone buildings sit alongside a futuristic skyline. UQ's St Lucia campus is home to Australia's largest rooftop solar panel system.
This would probably be about 250 homes.
It's driving research and advancing scientific knowledge.
And so sitting in between the glass and that's a good example, look, is a layer of ethyl vinyl acetate.
The solar array also provides up to 6% of the university's peak electricity demand, cutting carbon emissions and power bills.
And we think this system will pay back within about 10 years. That's based upon a cost of roughly $4.8 million for the system, which is 1.2 megawatts.
The system suits the university because production peaks during the day when demand is high.
For midwinter, this is an extremely good day.
The high cost of solar power has been its Achilles heel. But Professor Paul Meredith says the business case is becoming more attractive.
If you take a reasonably conservative view of what electricity prices are going to look like over the next decade, then probably in 2 to 3 years' time the case will be quite convincing.
He wants electricity grid managers to get on board.
The grid that we have was not designed to take lots and lots of sources feeding it at the same time. It's designed to take big power stations and then distributing that power amongst the users. And so we've got some quite significant challenges to redesign the grid to cope with things like two-way flow of electricity, which is going to be a major factor in the new energy system of Australia.
This shopping centre at Maruka on Brisbane's south side has embraced green power. A rooftop solar system 40 times the size of the average domestic setup powers the escalators, lights and security system. It's also good for marketing.
Here's an opportunity where people do their shopping in a green environment and see some benefit.
The owners would like to expand the project.
As the cost of coal-fired power goes up, and the cost of generating solar energy comes down, the crossover's got to be not far ahead of us. So these sort of things are going to become much more significant. And we saw an opportunity to do something as innovative, and maybe we can use the skills employed here to install this in other centres throughout Australia.
The solar industry says more businesses would follow suit if there was greater government support.
Most of the government-based incentives in Australia have really been targeted at residential systems. Some businesses have been able to sort of sneak in at the top end of that, if you like. We'd definitely like to see incentives of some description for commercial and industrial installations. That doesn't necessarily have to be a feed-in tariff. There are many types of incentive.
He says increasing the use of solar power will help make householders and businesses more aware of their energy consumption.
Once people have a solar system on their roof, they're much more inclined to pay attention to the power they're using and to be more energy efficient. I think that same concept needs to flow through to businesses as well.
The state government says it is looking at ways to encourage more business investment in solar.
We review where we're at with various forms of assistance all of the time to make sure that we are hitting the mark in terms of the outcomes that we're seeking.
And he says the federal government's carbon tax makes solar power more attractive.
The economics of converting over to solar without a feed-in tariff, I think, is not too far away, and that, I think, represents real opportunities for the commercial and industrial sector.
The future looks like a very much more diverse and distributed grid system and energy supply system for Australia.
And the LNP says it's in the process of developing a policy on solar power, but couldn't release any details.